the only power.
You're
the only power.
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS, who rule well, teach well, being great examples to his younger brothers, and peace and blessings, salutations to the hopeful elect out there pushing his word and truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopeful elect, the believers, the listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scripture through faith in Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. And, what I want to go into real quick, you know, is dealing with, you know, the sifting, you know, and the sealing. Okay, there's a great sifting, all right, that's going on, and there's a sealing of the elect, and we pray to be a part, you know, of this sealing. Okay, we want to be those that are sealed. You know, we're going to go into that, okay, with the fear of knowing that we at the mercy of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, and we can be sifted, okay? When this, you know, within your thought process, that keeps, you know, a level of fear and humility that's going to be needed, okay, to maneuver in these times, okay? With decision making in these times, fear and humility, okay, plays a major part in decision making. Now, what I want to start off with is Amos 9 and 9. It says, "For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations. Like as corn is sifted in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth." Yeah, so there's a global sifting of Israelites. Okay? And though the elect that are desired, those are the ones that will not fall upon the earth. You know? Those are the ones that are going to be kept, you know, through all these circumstances and events, you know, that's happening in the earth, the word going out, you know, the elect being edified, you know, different circumstances, trials and, you know, tests and you know, sacrifice and loss. That's a sifting process, man. And within that, the elect, okay, are going to be kept. Now, you're going to have times, okay? You're going to have simple moments as the elect. You know, as the hopeful elect. You're going to have simple times, man. Okay? But remember, we have a power, you know, that's full of mercy, man. And with those simple moments, we learn and get better and grow. We got to make the adjustments off those simple moments, man, during this sifting process, man, so we can be kept and sealed, okay? We want to be kept and sealed. Now, let's go here, okay? Which we know Yahweh Shah, all right? And this was the time of what? The Passover, matter of fact. Let's just read this. This is Luke 22:1. It says, "Now the feast of unleavened bread drew nigh, which is called the Passover," all right? So letting you know the time of the Passover, all right, was going on during the time that Yahweh Shah told Peter this in verse 31. You know, this is Luke 22:31. It says, "And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan have desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat." Okay, now let's get that word sift in the Greek. "That he may sift as wheat." All right, and the word sift,
Strong's G 4617,
Saniazo. Okay, and it says, "By inward agitation to try one's faith to the verge of overthrow, man. And Satan is working, man. Okay? Satan is working, man. That's why, you know, we can't drift away, you know, from a healthy spiritual regimen, man. You know, we can get caught up into, you know, life, you know, job, you know, different affairs, and it throws you off your spiritual foundation, and that's, you know, opening, all right, that's creating an opening for Satan, man. Okay? And we have to really, you know, guard our minds, you know, through this word, man, because this word is likened unto the blood on the doorpost of our minds, man, that's protecting us, man, all right, from Satan, which you're going to get it, okay? So, we in that time, as the Passover is approaching, you know, where spirits, you know, are heightened, you know, Satan is more active, your demons are more active, you know, and we have to get active, you know, in Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? And it's through humility. You see? It's through humility before, even before the works. You know, it's humility. True humbleness, man. Being in order. You know? That goes a long way. Now, a brother had brought this definition out on the comment board. And, you know, it was heavy. You know? When you go to Revelation 7:1, it says, "And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree." And see, that's the destruction, man. Okay, because there's angels that have charge over the destruction, you know, that's to come to the earth, man. Okay? And they have orders, all right, to hold back the wind until a particular thing happens, man. And it says, "And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given," okay, "to hurt the earth and the sea," all right, because it's finna be so chaotic in the earth, man. And this war, and mainly this war, this third world's war, hey, this is going to be a hell of a war, man. Land and sea. Okay, these powerful navies in the earth, these powerful armies and militaries and, you know, surface-to-surface missiles and, you know, it's going to be a hell of a war, man. You know? But, I want to get that word seal here in the Greek.
Strong's G, 4973, Sphragis. Sphragis.
Okay. And you go into it. I'm going to go to definition I. And it says, of the name of the Most High and Hamashiach, all right, Yahweh Shai, stamped upon their foreheads, just like in Revelation 14 chapter, man, showing that we will have those names, okay, within us, man. And truly believe on those names, showing that's a part, you know, of being sealed. That's a major part of being sealed. It says, definition D said, "that by which anything is confirmed, proved, authenticated, is by a seal, a token, or proof," man. Okay? The elect will be authenticated. You see? Before that destruction. Now, you go to this root word of seal.
Strong's G, 5420. Fraso. Fraso.
All right. To fence in. To block up. To stop up. To close up. You see that? To fence in. Okay. And the Passover is about us being what, man? Fenced in. Closed up. As destruction, all right, proceeds, man. But it's going to be those that have that seal from on high. Okay? Now, let's get one more definition, man. We want to be fenced up. Okay? And what's going to be fenced up? Our mind. Okay? And it's going to show it in this definition.
Strong's G, 5424. Frame.
All right, frame, which goes into the faculty of perceiving and judging. Okay, sealed with a mindset. All right, sealed with a spiritual judgment, spiritual discernment. Okay, the elect will be sealed in these times. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of our time. That's those that will have their seal. You know? So let's read this in verse 3. It says, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed, okay, the servants, all right, of our power in their foreheads. Now, let's get this word sealed. So let's get this word sealed, and this is the main definition.
Strong's G 4972. Sfragizo. Sfragizo.
Okay. Now you go to definition A and look what it says. For security from Satan. You see that? For security from Satan. Satan have desire to sift you. How should I say that? But the elect will be sealed, which would do what? Fence up our mind, okay? Close up our mind from Satan, to be secure from Satan, man. All right? And we have to use our spiritual arsenal, okay? Through fasting, prayer, you know? Obedience, humility. You see, we have to utilize these things, okay, to be remain secure from Satan, man. All right. So what we're seeing happening amongst, you know, our people, all right, is there's a sifting and there's a sealing, man, and we want to be part, you know, of the sealing, man. Okay, and it's through humility. Okay, and the good mercy of Yahweh Bashimah Shai. Okay, through obedience and faith, man, in Yahweh Shai. So Lord will, you know, you brothers, all right, you few sisters were edified. Till next time, I say Shalom. Kwam Yashallah, Abba, DTA soon.